Hello guys, welcome to the ninth part of creating an online food store using Angular. In this session, we want to do the Angular part of adding a tags bar here and make it like this. At the end of this video, we could have a tags bar like this and we could be able to click on them to filter the foods based on their tags. So stay tuned to the end of this video to see how. The first step is adding tags route into the routes inside the app routing modules. Jump into the code inside the Explorer, SRC, app, and app routing module. We need to add another route inside this const route. Okay. Its path should be tag slash and another route parameter, but this time it's not search term, it's tag. So we need to see something like this inside the route. For example, localhost 4200 slash tag, that is a literal text, this one, and the tag that is, for example, fast food. So whenever we get the tag with this route, the tag gonna be fast food. Okay, let's remove this. But where should it go? It should go to the home component once again. So the component should be home component. So whenever we change the tag, it's gonna show us the home component. And inside the home component, we can show all the foods based on the given tag. That's what we wanna do in the next step. Now it's time for adding the activated route inside the home component or listening to the tags route changes inside the URL, okay? We need to go inside the home component, home, and home component TS file. So we have the activated route already here. We don't need to add it once again. Here inside the route parameter changes, we have the search term from the previous session. Now we need to have another condition for the tags. So we should say else if params has a tag. And this tag comes from this tag name. So if you change it to tag one, this one gonna be tag one, so don't get confused about this. Exactly just like search term, as you can see, this is search term and the route parameter name gonna be search term. So this is tag, the params name for the second condition should be tag. So we should say if the params tag is not empty, it means if there is a tag inside the URL, then we need to set this.foods equal to this.foodservice.getAllFoodsByTag, and we need to pass the tag params.tag. But as you can see, we have an error because we didn't implement this getAllFoodsByTag inside the food service. That's what we need to do in the next step. So we did this. Now we need to go inside the food service and implement this getAllFoodsByTag for getting all the foods that have that specific tag. For example, fast food. Okay, let's jump into the code. Inside the Explorer, inside the services. Let's open up the food service and write the function that we want to use inside the home component for getting all the foods by the tag. And you know what the name of the function is? It is getAllFoodsByTag. Exactly the same name that we use inside the home component because we want to implement this function. And it has a tag input as a string and it needs to return a list of foods. So colon food array. Okay. Now inside this function, we need to return all the foods that has this tag. But we have a special tag. If the tag is equal to all, we need to return all the foods. So if the tag is equal to all, we need to return this.getAll, this function that's gonna return all the foods. Otherwise, we need to return all the foods that has this tag. So this.getAll, we need to filter the foods that food.tags includes this input tag. Now it's gonna filter all the foods that has this special tag. But we can write it cleaner. How can we do that? We can do it using ternary operator. This operator. Question mark, colon. It's like this. We have a statement. Is it true? Do job one. If it's not, do job too. It's just if statement, but it uses a single line and it's so cleaner. Don't need to have a lot of extra code. So how to do it? We can say return if the tag is equal to all question mark. So this is this statement. Now, if it's all, the first job is this dot get all. Otherwise, it needs to filter the result. So we can cut this from here and put it here. We can write it like this. So it's gonna be like this. So if the tag is equal to the special tag, that is all, gonna return all the foods. Otherwise, gonna return the filtered foods. Okay. Here we have the function. Let's remove this. So it's completely ready. And we don't have any error inside the home component for the getAllFoodsByTag. So it's done. Let's test it inside the browser. Here inside the navbar, we need to write the route similar to what we create inside the app.routing module. Something like this. /tag/all. As you can see, it's returning all the foods. So what if we say we want all the foods with the fast food tag? It's gonna return only the foods that has the fast food tag. So it works, okay? To this step, we are able to get the tags from the route and filter the foods based on that specific tag. Now we need to add the tags bar here between the search bar and list of the foods. Let's do this. Okay, we did this. Now we need to create the tag model for holding the tag's name and count of the foods. As you know, tags doesn't have a single value. It has the name and it has the count. We need both of them at the same time. So we need to create a model for them. Let's jump into the code and close these things. Here inside the Explorer, inside the shared folder, models folder, we need to create another file called tag.ts. We need to export class tag. The first property should be name. It's mandatory with the type of string. The second one is count, and it's also mandatory, and its type is number. Here we go. We have the tag model. We did it. Let's check this one. Now we need to use this tag model inside the food service for getting all the tags. Let's jump into the food service and create getAllTags function. Here inside services food and food service, we need to create another function called getAllTags. It doesn't have any input and it just return a list of tags. But we didn't import the tag here. We need to do it. Import tag from ... shirt models and tag. Here we go. Here we have the tag. Now we need to return all the tags. This data, just like this data, needs to come from the server. Okay. But we don't have server yet. We can mark the data that's gonna come from the server. So let's mark the data that we can get from the server. Okay. The tags data gonna be like this. These items should be calculated inside the server, but here we don't want to talk about the backend side. Once we start the backend, we can remove all the things and we can get these things from the backend side. So getAllTags function is ready. Now our data for feeding the tags component is ready. So let's check this one and start creating the tags component. The first thing is generate. So let's generate the tags component. Let's jump into the code, close these two. Let's open up the terminal using control backtick, the key under your escape key. Press this plus icon. We're creating a new terminal here. Write ngGc for generating a component and the name of the component, that is tags. Okay. Enter, and the tags component is ready. Let's jump into the tags folder, and we have all the things about the tags component. So it's ready. Let's check this one and go over to adding the tags property. Here inside the tags component.ts file, close this. We need to add a property called tags that is of type tag array. We don't have tag here. We need to import it. But if you already installed the Angular Essentials version 11, you can easily press Control dot instead of writing the import here and choosing the first item, that is import tag from module shirt models tag, and it's gonna be here and you don't need to write it by yourself. that can help us to write our code faster. The default value of the tags should be an empty array. Okay, we made the tags property. Here we go. We need to jump into the template file and add the div as the container of the tags. Let's do this. Here, inside the tags component HTML file, let's remove this. Let's write a div. Here we need to write ngIf the tags.sum. It means if the tags array has some item inside it, okay? Then show this div, okay? That's the second part of the template file. Let's check this one and let's show all the tags using a tag and ngFor. Let's do this. Here we need to write an a tag and ngFor to loop through all tags. So let each tag of all the tags. So it's gonna show from the first tag to the last tag that's inside the tags array. I wanna show the tag using interpolation. I wanna say tag. Name, but we also need to show the cont. So we want to show the cont inside parentheses, literally parentheses. And inside the parentheses, we want to show the cont using interpolation, tag.cont. So it's going to be shown like this. And whenever we click on a tag, it needs to go to that tag's special page. So we need to use router link. That is a special link for Angular that can do client-side route changes. We need to say go to the tag route and as the parameter set the tag.name. Here we go. So it's gonna go to exactly the same route that we defined inside the router. First literal tag, and the second one, the value of tag. So for example, slash tag slash fast food. But we didn't use this tags component anywhere. As you can see, it's name app-tags. We need to go to the home component template file and use it between the app search and list of the foods. So here, app-tags. Here we go. Let's see the result. As you can see, nothing changed because we didn't set any value to the tags inside the tags component. We need to inject the food service here, private food service. And food service, this is the name of the class, the Angular Essential, gonna do import automatically for me. And I don't need to import it by my hand. So I have this inside my constructor. So it's a property inside this class. Now I can use this food service inside the ngOnInit and set the this.tags equal to this.foodService.getAllTags. Now if you look at the result, you can see once again, we don't have the tags here. I think it's because of the sum function that we used inside the tags component. We don't need this actually. So let's remove it. That's fine for us. Let's save and see the result. As you can see, we have all the tags here. Now let's click on them. Fast food, pizza, lunch, slow food, hamburger, fry, and soup. As you can see, it works like a charm. So this part is finished, but we have a bonus step here. Let's check this one two, and check this one three. Okay, that step is move the search filter from home component into the food service. Let me show you what I'm talking about. Here inside the code, inside the home component TS file, we have this ugly code for filtering the foods inside the home component. It's not part of home component's business, okay? We just need to define a function inside the food service and we need to give it a search term and it needs to filter the foods based on that search term. That's it. So let's cut this from here and write this.foodService.getAllFoodsByTag. Term. Let's pass the search term here, params.searchTerm. Okay, here we go. But this function doesn't exist. Let's go into the food service, inside the services, food service, and add another function here. GetAllFoodsByTag. It has an input that is search term of type string, and it returns a food array. Here we go. We just need to return this because we are already inside the food service. We don't need to write this.foodService. So let's remove this food service and this.getAll. Gonna call the getAll function. And instead of this params.searchTerm, we have this search term input here. So let's remove the params and it needs to work. Let's see the result and do the search, for example, meat and it works. And if you look at the home component, you can see it's much, much more beautiful and it's easy to read. If there is a search term inside the parameter, get all the foods by search term. If there is a tag inside the route parameter, get all the foods by tag. Otherwise, get all the foods without any criteria. Okay, we did it. If you have the tags bar here, feel free to ask all of your questions and anything that may confuse you. I'm ready to answer your questions. In the next step, we're gonna put this